The streets of the town are deserted. The number of missing persons is also increasing. 89 days ago, the Earth was invaded by unknown creatures. Many places are in a state of lockdown. This unknown creature has no eyes, but the hearing is extremely sensitive. If someone makes a sound, they will become the target of the monster. The monster's movement is very agile, and there is a hard outer layer of armor on its body. This is why it is difficult to deal with. The world is also in crisis. The Abbott family lives near three such monsters. On this day, the family came to the supermarket in town to search for supplies. Regan was born with a hearing impairment. Marcus is sick and needs medication. Bo imagines that he can escape from Earth by rocket in the future. But Regan knows that this is impossible. Bo then goes to grab the airplane toy on the shelf. The plane almost fell and made a sound. Luckily, Regan catches it just in time. Then they found all the supplies and were going back the way they came. But Bo actually put batteries on the airplane toy. Lee carefully took the toys and removed the batteries and put them back on the counter. The plane makes a sound, so it's a safety hazard. Regan saw that her brother was disappointed and gave him the toy without batteries secretly. But what she didn't know was Bo took the batteries back when she wasn't looking. On the way, they walked on the prepaid sand. Lee carried the sick Marcus in the front. Evelyn and Regan followed closely behind. Just as they were about to cross an iron bridge, the sound of a toy came from behind them. But Regan, who was deaf, didn't notice it right away. Lee dropped Marcus and rushed to Bo's rescue, and Evelyn was also scared and cried out. Regan turned around and saw the toy in Bo's hand, lit up with colored lights, before she realized the seriousness of the situation. Lee ran towards Bo desperately, but in the end, the monster rushed out and killed Bo. A year later, they planted crops nearby to provide food reserves. Surveillance was installed to watch the monster's movements. Lee tried to contact the outside world, but never got a response. Regan would accompany her mother into the fields to plant. Marcus always imagined he could learn to drive. The family gradually got used to the quiet life, and Evelyn was pregnant again. During this time, they prepared oxygen and a speaker for the baby to be born. They soundproofed the entire delivery room. After dinner, the two children played flying chess. They accidentally knocked over the lantern. Lee found it and rushed to put out the fire. They were worried that the sound might attract monsters, so they cautiously looked out the window, but all they found was a raccoon. It was because of the raccoon that the family escaped death. Lee had been helping Regan improve her hearing aid, but it never worked. Evelyn also checked her health every day, because she was doing 20 days. Regan hadn't been in the basement all year. Curious about what her parents were doing in the basement, she wanted to go down and see what was going on, but Lee stopped her. Regan didn't understand what her father was doing and was furious. Lee then pulled out his new and improved hearing aids, but Regan refused to wear them because they never worked. But Lee slips it into Regan's hand anyway. Evelyn was teaching Marcus his homework, and Lee was going to take him out on a fishing trip. Marcus didn't want to go. Evelyn said, "Your father wants you to learn to take care of yourself. In the future, you can take care of me too." Before the trip, Regan also wanted to come along, but Lee wanted her to stay home and take care of her mother. For this reason, Regan was also angry again. She tried to put on a new hearing aid, but the hearing aid was still broken. Regan feels that her father keeps her out of everything because of her brother's death a year ago. If she hadn't given Bo a toy, or if she could have found him in time to save him, then maybe Bo wouldn't have died. They went to the river, and they did catch a fish in the fishing gear they had put there. Lee tries to kill it on a rock, but his hand slipped and the fish got away. Marcus was afraid that the sound would attract the monster, but Lee tells him that it's okay. Regan takes up his backpack and goes to see the dead Bo, and Evelyn takes her laundry to dry alone. She goes upstairs and a nail gets stuck in her pocket. Evelyn yanked it free, but the nail, which was upside down, stood up with it. Lee led Marcus to a waterfall. They could not only speak freely under the sound of the water, even shouting was not a problem at all. Marcus asks Lee if he didn't bring Regan because of Bo's death a year ago, although everyone was very sad about it, but Lee did not blame anyone. Regan felt remorseful. She goes to the place where Bo died and puts the toy airplane with the sound circuit cut off in front of the tombstone. Then Lee found a house on her way back with Marcus. There was an elderly couple living here, but the old lady died because of the monster's attack. The old man didn't want to live, even after seeing his wife leave. He suddenly let out a loud scream. Lee rushed to take Marcus to hide behind a tree in the distance. Then they witnessed the scene of the old man being killed by the monster. Soon it was dark. Evelyn, who was home alone, was suddenly in labor. She went down to the basement to prepare for the birth in severe pain. On her way downstairs, she stepped on the nail that had been erected. She didn't dare to scream out, but the frame fell to the floor. She knew that the sound would attract a monster, so she moved her foot away from the paint. She switched the outside lights to red to warn Lee that something was going on in the house. Just as she was about to go up to get something, the monster had arrived. By now, the pain was too much for Evelyn to bear. She had to use deep breathing to relieve herself. In order to distract the monster, she set the timer and hid in the corner. As the bell rang, the monster also rushed forward, and Evelyn took the opportunity to escape from the basement. She was about to leave the house when she found another monster outside the door. Lee sees the red light and realizes that there must be trouble in the house. There is a monster loitering at the door of the house. Lee asked Marcus to light the fireworks in order to distract the monster. He then gets a shotgun and goes home to save Evelyn. Meanwhile, Evelyn has nowhere to hide, so she hides upstairs in a bathtub and prepares to give birth. And with the fireworks going off in the distance, Evelyn's severe pain was finally released. Regan, who stayed at the bridge with Beau, saw the fireworks and rushed home immediately. When Lee arrived at home, the monster had already left, and Evelyn had successfully delivered a baby boy. Marcus was returning from the fireworks when he suddenly heard strange noises coming from the neighborhood. He rushed towards the cornfield in fear, but he crashes into a tractor tire and passes out. Lee carried his wife and son to the soundproof room prepared in advance, but the baby's cries drew the monster to him. He put a mask on the baby and placed it in a soundproof box. Regan returned and saw a bright light coming from the cornfield, so she leaned down to check it out. At that moment, the monster suddenly appeared behind her, but she didn't even notice. The monster opened its ears to search for nearby sound sources, and this caused the noise of the hearing aid. This high-frequency sound wave is very uncomfortable. The same monster also cannot stand. Then the monster quickly fled the place, and the hearing aid returned to normal. Evelyn woke up from her nightmare. She regretted not holding Beau. Maybe he wouldn't have been killed by the monster. Regan followed the light source to the inside of the cornfield. Here she also found Marcus, who had just woken up. Then the two of them climbed up to the granary and waited for their father to come to their rescue. Lee saw that Evelyn was fine before he came out to look for the children. But when he left, he did not notice that the water pipe was left open. As a result, just a moment after leaving, the soundproof room was filled with water, and the sound of the water also attracted the monster. Evelyn quietly went to carry the children, and the monster was right in front of her. She held the children in fear and hid behind the curtain of water, and Lee found the children's belongings. Regan wanted to go home, but Marcus wanted to wait for help. Marcus suddenly fell into the granary, and this sound also alerted the monster in the house. At the same time, Lee heard the sound. Marcus in the granary trying to grab a flashlight aside, but the more he struggled, the faster he sank, and the falling barn door also nearly hurt Marcus. Regan had to jump down with him. She pushed the barn into Marcus' hands. Marcus climbed up, but Regan sank. Then Marcus went back to save Regan, although in the end they were both rescued. But the monsters arrived at that moment. They turned the door upside down and covered the body, but the hearing aid makes noise again. Regan was very uncomfortable, and the monster was even more frantic. And then the next second, the monster ran straight out of the granary and escaped from here. And they both have no idea what just happened. Lee had just found them when he heard the sound of the monster coming from nearby. He told the children to hide in the car. He took an axe from the carport, and at that moment, the monster was on the roof of the shed. Lee realized this, so he swung the axe at the monster. He was instantly knocked aside by the monster. Seeing his father hurt, Marcus did not help but cry out, and this also led the monster to their side. With the monster approaching, Regan's hearing aid also emitted noise again, because the sound is really uncomfortable. So she turned off her hearing aid, and that made the monster even more unrestrained. Lee was wounded, but he was barely able to stand up. He said in sign language that he loved Regan very much. Then Lee shouted at the monster, and the monster heard him and came straight towards him to prevent his father from dying like this. Marcus released the handbrake and drove towards home. When he got home, it was already light, but the monster hadn't gone far. The three of them then hid in the basement, and this is the first time Regan has been in here. Regan saw this and seemed to understand her father's intentions. He tried his best to help her improve her hearing aid. At this moment, Regan's tears also instantly fell down. At that moment, the light suddenly flickered. The monster had followed the noise and arrived here. Evelyn wanted to shoot at the monster, but the outer layer of armor on its body was hard to break, and the sound of gunfire will attract more monsters. At this point, Regan suddenly noticed Lee's research. Although he knew a lot about the monster's characteristics, but he didn't know what the monster was afraid of. Regan thought of the monster's escape in the granary and suspected the hearing aid that always made noise. She tries to turn on the hearing aid that makes noise. Regan was in a lot of pain, and the monsters also very painful. At this moment, they finally figured out the monster's weakness. So they are afraid of high-frequency sound waves. At this point, Regan also saw the microphone and headphones next to her. Then she pressed the hearing aid to the side of the microphone. At this moment, the original noise through the headset was amplified several times. Under the interference of such sound waves, the monster's skull instantly cracked open. Evelyn found the right moment to shoot the monster's head off. A mother and daughter killed the monster that the National Army could not solve. At that moment, they discovered through the surveillance, the other two monsters nearby also heard the sound of gunfire and came here. But they weren't scared. Regan turned up the volume of the microphone to the maximum. Evelyn is also ready to fight. This is the end of the movie.